What's up, guys? We are here with z0mOG versus obii. Obii brought stall. What the fuck, dude? So he turned out to turn one with Landris. I'm just caught off guard. I thought this game would be in 30 minutes on 1 hour. Megan, go for the auto win if you can't outplay my man. Or you can't outplay. It's just a quote, you quoted someone. Oh well, this is interesting. To see if z0mOG can break. He's probably Z. Seafly Dragon Knight. I mean, not sure why he went into Metagross. Like, I get that he doesn't want to go into Fini and lose his leftovers, but oh, I guess he's trying to pivot. He's trying to get this 50-50, right? Like, go into Fini now on the Will-O-Wisp. I get what he's trying to do. Yeah, I guess that was well played, yeah. So like Fini gets to keep his leftovers, which is nice. Metagross only took 23. So the taunt is pretty obvious. You just got a Pex, right? Nature's Madness is, yeah, that's also a fine play. Just hard meta, cannot get burned. Misty Terrain is up, so he will just fish for Mash Boost or Thunder Punch. Oh, then Headbutt, in case he wants to stay in with a Toxic Pex and a T-Punch. Sigh, why is this thing still in OU Ducky? I'm so mad, dude. So it is Spikes, Skarm, which he will get off his Spike eventually. So he trades, actually that 8, that Sableye is really spadaff, good god. The Moonblast did less than 50. He's gonna pivot from Chansey into Toxapex here. Pretty sure he's gonna go Toxapex. What? He Seismic Toss predicting Taunt. Man, z0mOG explained as well. This is either Chopple. I think it's Chopple on the Ferrothorn if it's not lefties. Dang. The Sableye is so annoying, just gets off the knockoff now, yeah. Like, z0mOG is playing this decent, but the matchup, dude, I don't think he can win. And this time I am serious. I know I might upload this before the Auras games, but there were some Auras games earlier and my analysis was not on point. But this time I'm really 100% sure that, like, z0mOG has really bad matchup. He has to like outplay really hard to have a chance. And even then, since the Fini lost its lefties now, it's just gonna get warmed down. If the Ferrothorn gets Scald burned here, it's basically like super over. I mean, not that Ferrothorn does anything to obii's team, but it's just like more chip damage. Oh my god, it's over. It's over. Click X. I mean, like, that's just more chip damage you take on Fini, you're forced to default. Like, I don't want to like sound like a douche or anything. I'd be so mad at my opponent for being stalled in this peel. Like, I know I use stall myself sometimes, but like in a tournament match, like, cause I think z0mOG is trying to have fun. I think his team cannot make playoffs anymore, if I recall correctly, so he's just trying to bring some fun stuff. And yeah, if you face stall, then it's just really annoying. But I guess it'll be just sort. That's a free win. Like, you cannot say anything against stall. It is a playstyle. But if you would ban Dougie, which removes certain things that beat stall, it's just like more interesting in my opinion. The stall players have to play better in my opinion if Dougie wouldn't exist. Like, it's harder for them. They have to like prep for these counters, like, for, they have to prep for stuff like Hooper, or try to outplay stuff like Hooper, which is really hard. How do you outplay a banned Hooper if you don't have a duck cheat to trap and revenge kill? You don't outplay it with Storm if you have a man in the bus. Which just makes the game, like, more interesting. Which, if Ducky would have gone banned. So he has T-Punch there. Makes a really nice play. Obi maybe thought he only had Zen Headbutt because he went for that earlier. Because you don't see the combination of Zen Headbutt and T-Punch often on Mirrors. Like, in this game, the Ducky doesn't even matter that much because the Metagross is already brought down pretty low. I could see the Ducky being toxic. A potential double and Landris from Zamok's side actually could be a potential threat to. Okay, I said potential way too often. Could be a threat to the stall team. So if this is like sub DD, it doesn't do anything. I don't think it does. Yeah, like I thought at the beginning it was Sky Strike, but I'm not sure anymore because the Ferrothorn revealed Stealth Rocks, right? So it could be Double Dance Landris or Zemoth Landris. Doesn't have to be Zemoth on this. But that's just what comes to mind when you look at the team preview. This could be off-plate. Shoutouts to user Sorry, we used off-plate Smackdown Landris earlier and just put in the work versus stall. It just, like, it puts in so much work versus stall. Gravity is also an option. But yeah, I like Smackdown to put in work. It's not the first time I've used that set, but his team was cool. With Ghostium Gengar, we blew that. That Toxapex away with Ghostium Gengar, that was funny. Yeah, it is true what ABR is saying. It is true that Zomo can't even beat stall that doesn't have a duck trio, but just in general, what I was talking about earlier. Duck trio is just, no, it's not competitive at all, dude. Like, you just remove the one or two things that can break stall in most matchups, and then bop. Toxapex plus Chansey plus Clef Waltz. Or Toxapex plus Sableye plus Chansey, whatever. Like, if Feeny had recovered, this would take a bit longer. Like, if it had something like, I mean, it's not a flying type, it cannot land Roost, but it had some reliable recover like Soft Bolt. But then Tapu Feeny already has 4 move slot syndrome. He just spams Scald. Like, as stall player, you just don't lose much. You can, like, even, you can afford to misplay a little bit because the matchup is just so much in your favor. But yeah, I should stop to hate on Obi. He's honestly, like, a cool guy, and like, I liked the team he had last week. There were just some specific little things that maybe he could have played a bit different. Or there was some hacks against him he'd have missed. That was annoying. Yeah, it's just over for Zomog since the Tapu Feeny got burnt now. I mean, it was over before that, but this just speeds up the process, right? Chansey Waltz is always, like, even if you gang shot, you have to, like, poison and then hope for a crit. Oh, he gets a crit. See, even the crit doesn't do it killed. I bet he got the crit poison that I was mentioning. Like, he's just gonna go to Toxapex. Oh, I thought he would go Toxapex, so he's hoping for the flinch. Or he predicted Toxapex, either or. Like, I guess he's just, like, trying to fight, he's just not giving up. But he honestly didn't have a win con. Like, I get not giving up, but, like, this was just over from, basically from team preview. And a bit disappointing, because I, like, it's almost 1 AM here. It's, like, not super late, because for some games, sometimes I stay up way longer, but still. I'm really mad that, okay, not really mad, but I'm a bit disappointed that ABR versus Zamrock got delayed. However you say it, like, they're playing on Sunday probably. They were supposed to play today. was hyped for that match, but it's all good. It's just annoying if there are like so many games on Sunday and they all play at the same time then. That's just a no-no, a no-no. Okay, that didn't happen, but fucking five. Jazzy's so fat, what the fuck? No crit, no justice, kick. I mean, you get trapped by Ducky anyway, even if you kill this. Missed to rub some salt in the wound. He could have at least prevented the 6-0 if he didn't miss that. Because the chance would have been super low. It doesn't really heal on much. Maybe it heals on the Pharaoh, but that's it. Not that score matters, but just saying. Chansey gets healthy at the price of losing its Violite. So he's going for the Ice Beam Freeze now. So I think he dodges Toxic. But yeah, it's over now. Mans kept missing Toxic. I thought he did Z-Move. Inferno Overdrive, so it's Fire Blast. Oh, is it not Fire Blast? What the fuck? I don't think it's Fire Blast. Fire Blast wouldn't have killed. Or maybe it is Fire Blast. Because he's special. I don't know if Fire Blast could have killed a chance. Nah, he was Dragon Dance. Nah, he was mixed. Ice Beam is just to kill Landris. Pretty sure that was Fire Punch, Inferno Overdrive, plus one. I mean, at least they get a kill, which is something. But yeah, like, I think z0mOG is trying to bring some nice sets. Last week he bought us a Lazo. He should have been in call for the game. The Genesis game versus... whatchamacallit, Genesis was Nintendo. I called like 40 seconds. Then I didn't want to ruin my video more. I mean, you guys will see it in the video. The one will probably go up before this one. Oh well. Was fun. Oh, is he Scarf Lando? He's probably Scarf Lando. And Edge was the only way to be able to hit the scum. Not that it matters at this point. Yeah, I just wanna get off this. I just wanna end this recording. Good God. Take me away. I hope there's another game that's a bit more exciting. But it should be like in the next hour because I don't wanna stay up much longer. I wanna cheat a little bit, you know, you feel me? I already recorded 5 videos or 4 videos today. I recorded 2 Ubers games. This is the second Sun&Moon I'm recording. I recorded 2 Ubers games. Okay, so it's already 6. I recorded live, so that's 7. Yeah, I recorded 7 videos today. Kek. Call me content producing. Now my toaster's on fire, 1 second. At least this man's is making it a bit entertaining or funny. Would have been really nice to have him in call. What was I trying to say? He's struggling. Yeah, I just want to get out of here. We can look at the score real quick. It's nice to see how we pick up the win, but eh. The game, I didn't like it. The game, I didn't like it. z0mOG vs obii is Classies vs Scooters. I don't want to look at the score at the moment. We'll do like an overlook on the score. Like I looked at the score earlier, Vids, I think. But I might like potentially spoiler another game if I upload the game in a different. If I upload the games in a different order, so let's not do that. Yeah, I'm just take me away, River. I'm out, friends. It didn't explode, thankfully. The you guys for watching. See you next time. Peace.